I'm Christine Kanana.
So how do you know Israel?
He's been my friend for a while. Mm-hmm. Yeah, we go to the same church.
I'm Robert Burale. I am a professional event host and the father of the most beautiful girl in Eastern Central Africa.
Do you ever get time to cook?
I do like cooking. Just the time that is not there sometimes.
I can imagine.
The last time I cooked was a few weeks ago. Uh-huh. I do a lot of takeaway.
But it doesn't show, you're not adding any weight.
No, you know, having such a body is not easy. It's a calling. So don't be jealous, sir.
He talks a lot about how he can cook and how it tastes great. So I was like, it's time.
It's time to frame in the challenge.
Yeah.
So do you accept the challenge to get in the kitchen?
Absolutely. So, I don't say no to challenges.
Who do you want to take into the kitchen with you?
There's this guy.
Yeah.
He's not a guy.
He's a guy. Yes.
Yeah, he's Big Ted.
Uh-huh.
Big Ted and I were actually housemates for a while.
Really?
Yes. I, Robert Burale, accept the challenge to get into the kitchen. And in that, I also nominate my very good friend, Big Ted, to come into the kitchen for him to just enjoy being beaten by a close friend.
My name is Thomas Kwaka. I'm actually a civil servant. I'm the director for strategy and events at the presidency, which means I work for the president.
You do, eh?
Hey.
That's a very nice job. I'm sure a lot of people don't want to do that job, eh?
It's an amazing job to be able to sit and make a difference in people's lives by basically your ideas.
Do you ever get time to cook?
Monique, I can't cook.
He's actually a good cook.
He cooks well, eh?
I'm a better cook, but he's a good cook.
I lived with Burale. I never ever saw him cook. Ever. Even tea.
He's cooked, cooked some meat. So I bought Eno just in case. but I didn't have to use it. He's creative. Yeah.
I mean, you also said you're creative yourself, eh?
Oh, I'm the king of creative.
Actually, I cook very well.
I thought so.
I'm a very good cook. Uh-huh. I wonder why Robert chose me. And you know he's funny.
Yeah, he is.
Funny looking. Sorry.
And you accept the challenge to get in the kitchen?
Well, this is Big Ted, you know, the man himself. And I'm up to the challenge.
You don't want the hair to fall in the hood?
Which hair? No, I'm asking.
Our today's menu is stuffed chicken, stuffed with spinach and the feta cheese with rosemary potatoes. Now you cut off the wings, you remove the bones from here, from this side.
Hamata!
If you don't have this one, you can use a rolling bin or you can even use
your shoes. Robert, kama huna hii foil, unatumia karatasi ya mkate. Nilimwambia atumie karatasi ya mkate kwa sababu hajakuwa exposed sana kwa hizi vitu. Huyu Robert alikuwa ananiuliza, tafadhali utukuseme menu ambayo iko na stove. Sasa unajua yaje kupika na.
So now we do our garlic.
Sasa wenye vidole nono like someone I know atakataje hiyo.
Hii unawekanga hivi, unaweka kama guard. Hii na guard ni vidole.
So Burale was teasing me about my fat fingers and saying that I'm not able to cut, but I'm the disc king. But the only French you speak is what? French fries?
Sasa tutatua spinach yetu.
Okay.
Sasa tutai chop chop.
After boiling?
Yeah.
Kuna pia mayai. Mshanga mayai itengapi kwa history. Kama mluya. Mimi kama mluya. Nilikuwa na shanga. Ni kwa nini tunapika kuku na mtoto.
So ulianza na onions, ukaenda kwa garlic, now with ginger. OGG.
I tried to crumb. So I started with OGG. There was onions. And then there was garlic.
Then the spinach. Ikiendelea kuiva. Nakata ile cheese, about 100 grams.
Hizi vitu umeweka, mtaani zinaitwa majets.
Majets.
Yes.
Big Ted seems more interested in addressing the audience.
Hii inaitwa kipindire mtu wangu, kipindire. Vipindi mtu wangu.
The big man was had a lot of stories.
It's just a strategy of war. You confuse your enemy with sideshows.
And I decided just to keep quiet and block his voice. It's easy to block his voice. You cannot block his figure.
Easy to do than nini. So to pick you too.
Both men seem lost in the world. Ted confesses as much to the chef.
I hope naelewa mzuri. Tunaenda poa.
Hapa chef tumelewa. If food sia mawaida. Mawaida. Wanataka sembe mtu wangu. Sembe.
You know, before the show, I said I'm very good in cooking. Eh? Let me just take a few words back.
I was a bit scared. I was like, oh my goodness, this is a case of eating humble pie.
But you can use a spoon just to stir it, eh?
Yeah, but the tossing is best because it doesn't break when you are tossing.
It might not break, but you might find it behind.
I wasn't going to toss because I'm telling you I was going to embarrass myself if I tossed.
I'm going to present you the plate.
The chef's meal is ready, and it's now time for them to taste and see what they're supposed to replicate.
Come on, this is etiquette 101. Mm. When you go for lunch or dinner with someone,
we wait until everyone is served.
Who came here with you?
It's all right.
Too yummy. I think he's a fantastic chef. Nice, soft, and we could test almost everything.
I think I'm ready for the challenge.
You're ready for the challenge? Yes. You think you might manage this?
Yes.
I'll be brilliant. Test.
Why be perfect.
Yeah, test and presentation will be A game. See you on the other side.
I want my things already. OGG, onions, garlic. Where is garlic? I know what I'm doing.
She actually had memorized this stuff.
Yes. No, this does not come in.
I don't know. You do what you have to do.
Sina frying pan kwa nini?
Si ndio hizi. Kwa nini?
OGG.
I told you, 46 years old. Memory zero.
Hang on a minute. There's something you need. What is he doing? Yes,
just in case he forgot that you're meant to use a grater.
No. I don't want to use it.
He's using.
Kila kitu imewekwa ndani. Wala la 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 la. Mchanganyiko maalum.
Ted, nipatie mwiko.
This is going to be very, very interesting. The styles are so different.
What else did you put on that thing?
This is a chicken, not a thing. You know, I'm a new man. You can't just disrespect this thing like this.
I like my onions brown, so I'm going to make sure they brown out. I know the chef wouldn't like that, but I like them a bit golden brown.
I don't think they're supposed to be this dark, to be honest with you. We'll stop asking the chef. Why are you talking to the chef? Ted was talking to the chef, and the chef was actually listening to him. And Ted is a very highly intelligent guy. He can ask question A, and he will answer, but he needed E.
Brother, did you hear about this Luya guy who was about to get fired? And he told the boss, if you want to rub me, you can rub me, but don't bring spots.
But don't what?
Bring spots. Usilete mchezo.
I need 100 grams of cheese.
Everything is here.
Robert has chopped up the cheese, but has no clue where it should go.
Where am I mixing this with? Cheese was needed. But when I chopped the cheese, I was like, okay, so what is this for? And if you saw it clearly, I even threw the cheese in the dustbin.
What? I was trying to be malicious by giving him a cabbage, just for to see how confused he would get.
There's a time I saw a big tent filling the carrots in the down on the floor. Then he noticed, and then I was watching at him.
Boss, your hands are happy.
Not on a breadcrumb.
Three part. Are you sure?
I'm not sure.
Nobody's gonna help you. No one's gonna help you, boss.
I see Brali, but breadcrumbing is chicken. Starting with the breadcrumb instead of the flour.
Remember, I'm a Luya man. I know chicken very well. I just didn't know the sequence. But I knew what needed to be in the chicken anyway.
It is a mistake. Yes, that's why you don't meant to put butter in a hot pan. It's because of things like this, okay?
16 minutes left on the clock, and Big Ted hasn't put his chicken in the oven yet. The pressure is definitely being felt in the kitchen.
We need more time. Did you use the milk?
So you leave me alone.
What milk? Is that milk?
Oh gosh, I forgot the milk for the chicken.
And you saw what happened. He got very confused. He didn't even use salt. Ana samezoea kwenda kwamba chumvi ile unapika. Sasa wase hapa ndio normal utokea kusema.
Oh, it become dark, eh?
Meshura, eh? Okay, I burned my chicken. Again, trying to catch up with time, trying to make sure that I get everything done. What you can do is you can just pour some olive oil.
Yani, kama umeungusha chakula. He's making it sound so exotic and you burnt your food.
Big Ted distracts Robert and sends him off in a panic.
Someone's chicken has just been removed from the fire. I don't know who's.
Someone's what?
Chicken.
So I went to check on my chicken.
The black one is his, eh?
He goes,
And he played a dirty hand by putting paprika where it was not needed.
This guy has caught something here.
What? How can it be me?
That's why Mungua.
How can it be me?
That's why Mungua.
Robert finally has his revenge and sabotages Big Ted's meal too.
No. Ololo, there's fire in the hole. Well, it's part of the game. I threw a bone for him to run after. Then I had some time to flavor his vegetables.
You're calling me and this is your thing that is bad?
What are you guys doing? Wait, I'm telling you to cut these things. You're just dilly-dally.
It's okay.
I am Ishura.
Okay, no time.
Hey,
is that what are you giving us? Burnt offering?
He has made chicken charcoal. Ted went to the oven and I had to follow him. Ted's chicken was like charcoal and I would not trust him not to switch his with mine. All right, I need some space.
Okay, 10, 9, 8, 7, 6, 5. This is so scary for anybody who wants. 3, 2, 1. Time up, guys. Time up, time up, time up, done.
Okay. Chef, what are you going to
do? What are you going to do? Let's put the food down.
Chef,
let's put the food down.
Put the food down.
I've let you down in one area.
What is that?
But not in the other areas.
Can you just put the food down?
Morales food, it was pretty amazing. The chicken was awesome. And the vegetables too, they were good. Though he forgot to put the salt.
You don't put salt because the people don't like salt. Ted, what's fine?
Here we go.
That is chicken burnt.
Yes, hold on. I think I want the camera to just have a look at the texture. There's a reason why it holds together.
The food looks scary.
It looks scary.
Mm.
Actually, my plate looks like somebody ate on it and left food.
He kind of burnt the chicken. That's the only thing that was a bit off. And he didn't get to cook the potatoes, so he didn't get to taste that.
You put chili in your cabbages, in your vegetables.
And I knew immediately the taste of my chicken. That taste will just explode in their mouth.
Oh, that chicken is good.
You're not even tested it for 3 seconds. Oh, it's good.
Chef, by the way, you're a very good chef.
Is he the host of the show?
No, he's not.
Chef, please don't play.
You did a very good job. Yeah, your chicken was quite okay.
Actually, your chicken was very good.
Chef Clonzo is speaking. You are paid here.
Yours was also okay, although you forgot the cheese.
Then there was another defining factor.
Okay.
His meal was more complete than your meal.
All right.
So by virtue of that fact, the winner today in Get in the Kitchen with the big guys is none other than Mr. Israel Burale.
Thank you, sir.